Hello everyone. This is part three of the Cityville building process. This time around, I'm going to be concentrating on expanding the population of Cityville. It will involve some higher density developments. Since the last time, you can see I've expanded the highway network a little bit in the region. I've extended the main highway east, and the northern east-west route now comes down and joins up with it at a sort of Y-type interchange. I expect at some point I'll build a road coming down through Cityville East here. It'll probably continue down toward the shoreline here. But that's a different project altogether. Anyway, without further ado, back to Cityville. Okay, so the ultimate plan I have is this industrial area will bracket the highway here. It will go up to pretty much up to the city limit here. And then it will be mostly residential over here with some commercial scattered in. And then on this side, exactly what I do, I'm not quite sure yet. It'll depend on what happens with this pollution generating industry over here. Anyway, the first thing is I will extend the industrial development here. And once I've completed this, I'll also work on an interchange over here somewhere. As it seems like it really is needed. Ultimately will be anyway. Okay, clean up this extra stub here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, so based on this grid pattern, the crossroad would be the next tile up. It would be in the next city. Now, ideally this road would make a neighbor connection, but you can't do that with a street. You can, however, do it with a road. So this is the trick for making a neighbor connection with a street. You end up with a small bit of street on each tile on either side of the neighbor connection, but it's a street running up to it. This little stub here, unfortunately, is unavoidable. Anyway, now that the roads are present, I'll bring the water supply in. There's no need to make a neighbor connection with the water supply. We're not selling water to the neighbor, so there's no need. And now, I put in the zoning. Okay, so that's the industrial zoning. Now, how does the fire coverage play out here? Okay, so I'll need a fire station up here somewhere. Might as well build that while I'm thinking about it. And it should be fine over here. Yes. Okay. And back to the regular view here. Okay. I might as well bring the parkland all the way up as well. Since I did say I was going to maintain that green space. Since I have plenty of spare headroom in the budget, I can go ahead and fill this in. If you're wondering why I'm using the grass areas instead of the parks, it's mostly because the grass areas with trees have a consistent appearance from session to session, while the parks tend to spawn randomly with several different types. And that can really mess up the overall look of things. It works fine from a game mechanics perspective. All the various park variations behave the same, but it just looks wrong. Okay, so there's the grass areas. We need a neighbor connection here as well. And again. Okay, so this allows having the street for most of it, which it looks a little better that way. This little road stub is annoying, but unfortunately the game mechanics don't allow us to avoid it. Okay, now to put some trees in there, and which one was I using? I think it was juniper. Yes, it was juniper. Okay, so I'll fill in some trees here. Okay, so there's some trees. As you can see, there's plenty of demand for this industry here. Now, what I'm going to do is construct an interchange. And how many tiles did I need for this one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So I need about 12 tiles from the edge. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I should be able to line it up with this road. Okay, so that's where I'll put the interchange. At least I'll try to. First off, I need the bridge, which is under roads. Okay. There it is. Okay, level one. Okay. There we go. There's the bridge. Now, if I recall, I went three tiles out from the from the road. Okay, and then I came in and okay, so it's a little too close to the neighbor connector there. Okay, I'm gonna have to shorten this one a bit. Slopes can be problematic in these cases. Ah, there we go. That fixes the slope. Okay. Let's fix the... Oh my. Okay. This could be problematic. Okay. I'll see if I can get the slopes to fix here. Oh, right. I'm going to have to kill those. This is not fun. Okay, maybe that's enough. Apparently not. Why didn't that convert? Okay, I must have... Oh, it's the starters. Okay. Let's see if I can make this work. Okay. I'll replace the neighbor connection overlays in a moment. I need that tile back there. Aha! Okay. Now we're cooking with gas, as my grandfather used to say. Now. Maybe this would work better as a parklo. Maybe I'll do that. Let's see what I can fit in here. I wonder if one of the quick change pieces is the right one. Not really. I need it on the same level. What about the Flex fly stuff. No, not really. Okay. Okay, I'll build a diamond. To have this one tighter. Okay. See, if I were to move this one tile closer, the neighbor connection piece would overwrite this and the ramp would look wrong. So I can't quite do that. However, this should be function. This will be functional at the very least. Okay, let's see. Neighbor connection. I might change this to something like a park low later. Okay. Or I might just flip the ramps around. Okay, so the neighbor connection should be working now. Now let's see if I left enough room to get some curves in there. There we go. Probably not on that side. Okay, it fits there. Let's see. Curves. Where? Okay, there they are. Apparently it doesn't work. Dope. Now, let's try that again. Curves. A starter at the one end there. Wonder if that works. Can I build a road through a starter? Oh, right, okay. No, I can't. Okay, that's not going to work. If I want to use the curves, I can't quite do the interchange this way. Okay, I'm going to have to flip it. Okay. I could move the intersection right here, but that just doesn't seem right. Now, what I can do is a sort of this makes it slightly lower capacity, but it will fit. Okay, so a 90-degree curve on the RHW2. Okay, now theoretically, if we can fit in a folded Y, okay, ramps, we need a folded Y. There's the folded Y. There we go. Okay, so that's a folded. This is, folded means it's a sharp corner. This is a fairly tight setup here, so it's not all that unusual to have a tight interchange in here. But I'm going to go for a tighter corner here, as I think there is one, because it'll look better. And there's no need for high-speed traffic since it's already It's already lower speed. Yes, that looks a little less dumb. Okay, so that means we'll do the same thing on this side. Okay, we need that folded Y ramp again. Okay, there it is. There we go. Now I build the ramps. And there we go there. We link that up and that. And there we go. Okay. Just extend that one tile so that we can get this to set up properly. Okay. I suppose realistically we should set that up with a traffic light intersection. Okay. There we go. There's the interchange. It's rather tight, but it's also of relatively limited value to the local area. Not limited value, but relatively limited traffic. This isn't going to be a high density area here. I'll continue the lower density stuff in this area. And on this side, I'm not sure what I'm going to do. But I'll keep the higher density stuff down closer to the better capacity options for the interchange. Okay, so what I'm going to do now, I'm going to expand this section to a 6S. So this lane will continue through. It means I have to kill this ramp here, and I have to undo the connection here. Okay, now, right, actually, what I need to do first is make a hole here. Okay. Now, I think there's a flex for this. The flex ramps tend to handle the curves a little better. Okay, yes, that one's supposed to work with the 6. Okay. That's the one I want. Okay. Now, put a starter in here. There we go, 6S. There we go. Now, theoretically, yes, it converts. Good. Okay, now down at this end, I need the wide exit, so here we go. Whoops, there we go. Now I link that up. And finally, I reconnect the highway. There we go. If I were to extend this bridge one more tile, I could bring this ramp under and do a similar thing over here. But for the moment, I'm not going to worry about that. Okay, now over here, I'm going to add some more residential. Okay, now, there we go, and I should make sure there's water in there too. There. Okay, good. Let's speed that up so it fills in. What's the education situation look like here? Okay. Elementary. Yes, I'm going to need one over here. Okay. No, I put that further over. Yes. No. There. Okay. And yes, that should be fine. Now, where's the high school? Right, I'm going to need one over there too. Okay, so I'll put a high school as well. Where is it? High school. Put that there. Okay. Oh, I see. I can fill this in now. Now, let's see. Some more. Okay. Wait, hold up. We got an emergency going on here. And yeah, I'm going to get smacked for that in the news. Let's clear this out. Yeah, there it is. Mayor's dispatch finger fails. Now, I actually have the auto go to disasters thing turned off. The reason I have it set that way is because too many times the disaster has come and it has caused some random problem with construction where you end up with a road going all the way across the map through the middle of everything and destroying stuff you spent countless hours making work right or something like that. So I have that turned off. Now, for the most part, that's not a problem. Like once you have full fire coverage, you don't run into the fire problem very often. If you don't do dumb stuff with your city construction, you don't tend to get a lot of the other disasters like riots and so on. I kind of like these cul-de-sacs that are available on the roads in and streets in the North American textures on the NAM. Makes these dead-end roads look a little more sensible. Okay, let's put the speed back to something sane. Need to check on the water situation here. Okay. Okay. Okay, so that's more of the dense low density, I think I'll call it. All these one by one zones here, lots. Okay, let's go faster here again and finish filling this in. Okay. Now up here, let's spread it out again some more. So we'll use the three tile depth for the block width. Okay. Okay. There's some more roads. Let's slow this back down. Okay. Okay, now for some zoning. I'll put some commercial in over here since it has easy access to the highway. And we'll put some up here and here. And then make this residential. Bring the commercial over to here, and then okay, and residential there. Okay, now I'll make neighbor connections here. And tidy that up. And there we go. There, now that fills in. Now, we'll actually make a slightly better road coming through here, and we'll bring it down to the cut point here, and bring that across. Okay. Actually, we'll bring this one up to road level as well. Bring it across and down. Okay. Looks a little more plausible to have some higher capacity roads spread around occasionally. And we'll fill this in as well. Okay. Now, let's take a look at the crime stats. Crime. Here we go. It's still not that big of a problem. But it's really going to be necessary to start dealing with it. So I'm going to start building a couple of police stations. Okay, I use the large ones because they have decent coverage area, and they also have some inmate capacity. So I'll put a police station up here. And we'll put one put one here. And it seems reasonable to have one over here. Okay. Now, you can improve the effectiveness of the police by overfunding them, but you really don't want to do that. That will tend to cause additional problems. You can lead to your Sims feeling oppressed, and you really don't want that. Oppressed Sims will tend to riot and do other unpleasant things. And a police station over here. Okay. As you can see, the budget surplus is still quite significant, and I'm letting it run that way for a while, because it's always good to have a significant cash reserve just in case. At some point, I'll widen this out to an avenue type road. It's not needed just yet. You can see there's not a lot of traffic there, a couple hundred cars and the tightest spots. Oh, look at that. We have some traffic from this other community here. Which is heading up for work over in the industrial area here. As you can see, with the NAM traffic simulator anyway, it's smart enough to take the highway around instead of take this more direct route on the slower roads. Okay, so we've got the population up to 8,500 Sims now. Now, as you can see, we're not going to end up with a really large population if we continue building the city in a sprawling manner like this. So we'll definitely need some higher density development at some point. And I haven't quite decided exactly where to put that. It seems like maybe there would be a core over here with the higher density buildings over this way. Eventually, it would cover over the farmland here. But I might consider that this area will expand into the higher density buildings. Simply due to the fact that it's basically empty space around it. No, I'll start developing higher density over here. It fits in with this type of development here, so I think that makes sense. Okay, so I'll extend this road over here. And over here, I'll start with some medium density. Now, there's no point making this type of setup with the medium density. So I'll keep the four tile gaps here. And there we go. This is where we'll start ending up with traffic issues. Okay, so there's some medium density. And with the residential demand, it should fill in fairly quickly. And up here, we'll keep this grid going here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, and continue the road up here. Apparently, that doesn't want to connect. The slope must be a little too steep. Okay, yes, it must be. Anyway, I'm going to need the neighbor connection. I should be able to force this with a road. Now, if I remove that, it should connect now. Okay, that works. Okay, so we'll keep the low density here, and we'll go about halfway down here. Then I'll raise the density here. Whoops, that's not what I want. Sometimes a game is not very bright with laying out the zones. Like, that makes absolutely no sense. So the question is, why would it even do that? Now, just because the zones are for medium density, it doesn't mean that the denser buildings will grow immediately. Okay, water. But you definitely need the water supply for the bigger buildings to appear. Okay, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to bring a water across here. It's, you don't need connections across like this, but it's helpful if you ever end up renovating the water system. If you have multiple connections, you don't end up accidentally turning off the water to half your city when you kill an important connection. You can see some bigger buildings showing in here. Somewhere around here, I'm going to need a bigger capacity road to go through. Kind of like over here. I think I'll put it, I don't want to run into this. So I think maybe I'll put it I think I'll put it here. Yes, I'll put it there. Okay. And I'll actually bring it up this way, and I'll bend it across this way. So, now the question is, can I get it to bend apparently not no okay well there's something else I can try here and nope I want roads one-way roads. Okay. Nice thing is that avenues connect up with one-way roads quite seamlessly. Okay, now can I get one-way roads to... apparently that's not going to work either. Okay. Okay, so I'll end it there for the moment. Okay. Now, with avenues, you really do need to have periodic turnaround points. Intersections suffice for that. Otherwise, you can end up with... commute times and so on going way up in causing problems. Now, it's not so much of an issue somewhere like here, but if your avenue's headed for a neighbor connection, then you don't really get the turnaround. What was I doing? Oh yes, water. Okay. Okay, now I'm going to put medium density commercial along the avenue. And we'll go all the way up to the farmland. And it'll be on both sides of the avenue, a sort of main street here. And there we go. And whoops, residential on this side. Oh, all right, it's doing the dumb stuff there again. Okay, and we'll come down here as well. And this can be low density. Okay. Okay, so what have we here? Oh, we get another church. Let's put that church over here. Okay. Now you note that even though I've been constructing this in a grid pattern, the grid isn't a easy, you know, regular grid, and that so as you can see, you can get a fairly varied look by varying zone sizes and block sizes without having to do the random angle stuff like down here. I think realistically, this avenue is probably going to split and either have an interchange over here or a flyover and link up also with this road, which will probably mean expanding this interchange to an avenue over top. But the split will happen down here and it will, I'll have, a, I guess, a Y split in it. Perhaps I'll do that at a roundabout. Yes, a roundabout would make the most sense for one of those. Okay. Now the question is, what do I want to do with the avenue here? What options do I have? Okay. Wide radius curves. Yes, let's look in there. And what do we have? 45 degree avenue flex curve. And I can plop that on there. Okay, now. Aha! And we can't do diagonal. No, we can't have diagonal neighbor connections on an avenue. Okay. Now, where do I want it to line up? Oops. What I need to do is put that back. Okay. Wide radius curves. Now the thing about the flex curve is it gets the wealthification, the sidewalks thing. And where can, how close can I get it? Of course the terrain is not level, so I can't see what it's doing. Dope. No. Although that might be what I want for the ground there. Okay, let's try this one more time. There we go. This way, and no, I can't get that close. That doesn't line up. No, it doesn't. Okay. The way it wants to go, and no, that still doesn't line up. I need to go over here. I'll leave a placeholder there. Okay. Really? Think that lines up. Yes, it does. Okay. Bring the street over. Oh, that just looks nasty. What happened there? Okay. Dope. It's the intersection did it. Okay, so I need to bring that further down. Let's try that again and see if it can work. I think I can go up one higher there. Okay, let's try that again. Yes, that looks okay. That doesn't line up. See, it's hard to judge this stuff when you don't have flat land. That lines up. Okay. Does it? No. No. Let's see. That works. Okay. And what's going on here? Abandoned due to commute time. Okay, we're starting to get to the point where it's taking too long to get to the jobs. Okay, let's put some commercial along here. Okay. So if you're wondering what I did here, as long as one piece of the lot fronts the road, you can put stuff in front of it in other places. Okay, so we're starting to see no job zots here. So it's time to add some more commercial stuff here. Now, right. Okay, that looks stupid. Okay, that looks less stupid. Okay, so we have. Okay, we can have a city hall. Let's put that in there. That seems like a reasonable place for it right there. Ooh. I think that was the courthouse. Not actually available. That's why it was faded out there. Okay. So this is the start of sort of a main street type street here. I'm not sure when I'll start deleting the farms. But I'm sure it will happen in the next couple of parts, for sure. And fairly quickly over here, I think I'll get into some high density zoning. I'll try and remember to dig up the tree park stuff so that this stuff is a little easier to construct. But that said, I may just leave that the way it is. Okay, so over here, I think I'll have the higher density core here with much more commercial over here. And I guess what I'll do before I call this part, I'll fill this in with some additional industrial. As you can see, there's still demand for it. Okay, this is as far as I want to go on that. And come up to here. Okay, and I definitely need to make sure water is there. It will be, okay. And fill it in. Okay. Give it some time to fill it in. Okay, I'll forego the flyover option here. It's not really needed. This isn't that far apart, so there's really no need for a flyover here. If I did, I'd have to pick it up back here and go over this street. Actually, I'll just do that. And this will convert to a road. Or it should. Let's take a look here. And I'll slow this back down now. Okay, it's under roads, viaducts. What do I have? One level transition. And I'll bring a road over to the base of it. And a road over the top of this stuff here. You know what? I'm going to make things symmetrical, so I'll have two tiles, a street, that's a placeholder, and I'll need the bridge going down again. There it is. Okay. One level road. There we go. So that's going to be a flyover. There will be no connection with the freeway from it. This street will continue under. Okay. I've actually seen road setups like this in real cities. Anyway, I'll leave that as it is, and I'll call it a part here. And yeah, next time I'll do some further development over here, I think. And note that we've gotten up over 12,000 Sims now. Okay, so back to the region. Okay, so you can see the new development here. There's that green space here going up. You can see the older trees down here and the younger ones here. Okay, so thank you for watching part three. I'll see you guys in part four.